A story when I was young, my mother was war. So I found my weapon in swords, carved shapes that became letters, so anytime she raised her trigger fingers to me, I would simply be collateral damage for the words on the page. When he broke my heart for the first time, I ate the dictionary and became a linguist. I tried to find a word in the English language to adequately describe the crushing of my lungs when he broke my heart for the second time. I ran to fill my notebook with words, poured my pain upon those pages and that was the first time words and I ever argued. These words have become my best friends. The keepers of my secrets, my war and my peace, in the times I have felt like I wanted to die. These words have been my survival. These words are my anchor, these words are my life support, so I beg of you. Before I am 6 feet beneath the soil, before armies of ants turn my body into their fortress, speak of me as I am. Nothing extenuate or set down in malice, tell them that before anything else, Michelle Namsukumisa was a writer. Tell them that before anything else, Michelle Kumisa was an explorer of words and therefore a founder of words. Thank you. Okay. So the second poem I'm going to do is a poem I wrote about 4 years ago when I was becoming interested in sort of like the Black Lives Matter movement. And this poem is called For My Future Son. This comes many years too early, but how oft I think of you. How every fibre of my being will lay panting in the maternity ward. Thoughts scattered like bodies in the midst of a typhoon, trying to make sense of the Armageddon my body just endured, then I lay eyes on you. My own rescue mission. I imagine I will cocoon you in my arms like oyster shells guard lives. How your blood-smeared, alien-like hands will tug onto mine as if to assure me that you already know that life is war. But you've already conquered. You're already here. So in these quiet moments, alone, when the warm rhythms of your heart and breath are my life song, sounds of your pure lips upon my breast and watching you sleep are the only home comforts my heart knows we need to talk. This world is nothing without love. I need you to carry love like it is your last name. Sculpted in the marrow of your bones, engraved in your DNA, be a smile, a hug, be laughter, love. When that girl curls herself into a corner at the lunch table, eyes heavy with the search for a friend, you are never too cool to say hi, make her smile, love. If I'm ever foolish enough to tell you that big boys don't cry, then correct me and say, yes, they do, and yes, you will, and if it will help the pain subside, then cry until there is a drought in your eyes, cry. The above is one of the only times you may ever talk back. Your mother carries the heat of Africa in her right hand. She will smack you if you talk smack, but you are free to cry. Free. You are free. The world has too much space for you to have to attempt to fit in. You are not luggage at an airport, a stampede escaping a bomb site. You are human and you are free, free. Some people are not okay with the way the sun makes home under your skin. How your melanin in times past praised the face of Egyptian statues and conveniently forgotten king. You are a king and you are free. Contrary to police belief, your blood still bleeds red. So when he rolls the dice, fails to take notice of the white and sees your face in the black dots, make it clear that your life is not up for gambling. If you go on to find chains about your wrist, remember the truth your mother taught you of slavery. Remind him that you are not a statistic, you are a living being and you are free to live, live. Drink and be merry. If you find a woman, regardless she's the one that you will marry, love her. Until her insecurities burn and her scars fade, hold her. Until she believes in happily ever after again. Your manhood is not power. It is a pen of the rarest kind. Created to create art in the notebook between her thighs. Love her until you believe the earth is flat without her. Love. The world has hung its bleeding heart. A spectacle and life support, but love is there. Love cares. Love bled. Christ is love. My son, as you grow. Remember the lessons your mother taught you in these moments alone. Know that everything will work out for your good if you surrender all to He who gave Himself on the cross. He whose body became sin so that your body could feel the wonder and splendor of a life lived with Him. My son, take heed to these words. I will not worry about where your feet may step. As long as they are in the arms of the King who knows best, I will not worry about where your feet may step. As long as they are in the arms of a King who is perfect. Thank you. Barely 2 feet tall, crowned with a cake of cloud about her head, and her skin was caramel coated midnight. She danced with angels and flew with fairies, moved with mermaids and walked with unicorns. Her voice was certain, barely a whisper, but still conviction in a room full of sin. She was quiet, confident. She grew. And in mind. Her brain was an industry of its own kind, a maze to navigate, a field to explore. Her voice, still a trumpet. She found love in a man who was much like herself. One who saw seeds for the lilies that would one day become, and one who saw soil for the fertilizer it really was. He was a surgeon. Forever drowning in himself just to pour into others, this man was an artist, always ready to coat her pain with his pain, always creator, always idealist, never loyal. She swore she would never enter the barrel of her love again, but she did. This time, for a man whose hand was quicker than his heart. A man whose feet were known for trampling and whose eyes were an AK-47. If she smiled wrong or for too long, he beat her. He beat her black and blue. He beat her as dark as the sky with no moon. He beat her till there was no more room to be herself. No more use in caring for her health. He beat her until she saw herself the way his fist saw her. Her voice became a whisper. No certainty, no conviction, just a whisper. And like a whisper in the wind, she ran. Bones locking at every turn and with every urge to turn back, still, she ran. Eventually finding home in the arms of men and women for whom she existed as a pawn, a chess game made out of this queen, but her value unrealized.